Okay, gonna have a little bit of distraction here. A lot of traffic. Today is November the 11th, Remembrance Day. And a lot of people showed up. It was good. Okay. Remembrance Day, freedom, democratic system, everybody's treated equally. What, not in those days, but you know, that's the bottom line, that everybody will be able to express themselves in a free society, which is something we do not have here in Fredericton. This week was a rough week. It was a very rough week. It started with social development. A little bit dense again. A little bit cross-eyed. It started with social development, with the battle with them and my pension, which personally I don't give a damn. But as usual, this has absolutely nothing to do with me. This is the system that we're fighting. And the system is corrupt. There's no justice for the people that's on social system. And utter social, people on social assistance, there's no justice whatsoever, because the people on social assistance are treated like animals. They allow you the right to speak and whatever, especially in the justice system. We know the whole story. There's no, I told Judge Judy Clemente the last time that I was here when McGinnis Cooper held me in court, I said, you people, you hate us. The judges and everything, you hate people on a social system. People that will fight for themselves and fight against the system. They hate us because in their mind, it's a waste of avenue and time. It's like a no social club that, you know, everybody will be okay. You know, the lawyers belong to that social club. The lawyers are the prosecutor and the defense lawyer, they're all together. Okay, never mind that. This week, I will be focusing on social development. I'll call it the welfare high-class bureaucrat that's going against the less fortunate, and especially the senior. I am very, very upset of the manner that I was treated. I was treated like a piece of trash. And the problem we're having is there's so many issues. Everything happened all at once. But the bottom line is they want seniors to turn, go into bad health and die. That's the bottom line here. And this is very, very important that we address the issue of seniors on social assistance this week. A lot of people will say, well, okay, what's the big deal? There's a lot of issues. They stress out the people on social assistance that's not able to defend themselves against the bureaucratic system. And the bureaucratic system is a bunch of snobs. Remember that video? Do you have a ticket? Do you have a ticket? You know, that's the attitude against people on social assistance. These people are in a position to really, really do a lot of damage to the seniors of New Brunswick. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna start doing a series, and you're gonna find out the whole thing. You even have activists, people that claim to fight for people, the poor people, but when it comes to push and shove, no. One example, right quick, I think I'll mention it again in the future, is the system to, how come cars are stopping here? The system goes to pass laws inside this building. I'm jumping all over the place, too many coffees, too many distractions. They pass laws behind there, and those laws are enforced. If you want changes in the law, you have to lobby. Okay, you have to lobby the government to make sure that they change it. Okay, that's the problem. Now, people that's on social assistance can't lobby. They don't even know who to talk to. They think their caseworkers are God. So, what I've been told by one, this is one story, and I'll bring it up again. Someone that I thought was gonna stand by me and fight this thing, I got a hearing November 19th, suddenly come out with these demands. And one of the demands is to lobby the government to make changes. It's not the fault of Kathleen Ford that sent me the letter, and she's gonna fight on behalf of social development that people on social assistance should only live on $250 a month. I should just take, if I take his command, just drop it. Whatever the decision comes out, we set up meetings with the bureaucrats, and then we lobby the government to have the seniors to get more money. Now, my style is to hunt down the politician once they leave that building, hunt them down on the street, like I did with the prisoners that were forced to walk home. That's gonna change. Or the rooming homes that they get rights. All kinds of issues. There's two things to lobby. You contact the right person, you sit down with the bureaucrats, and then you make changes. That takes about a year and a half. If you turn around, if you do it the way I do it, it takes a little bit longer maybe, but it brings the issue to life. Now I'm gonna be talking in details more about it. So all week, all you're gonna get is social development going against the seniors to make sure that they die. So stay tuned. What a system.